Today we are gonna merge OpenAI's GPT-3 with Midjourney. So basically, AI is gonna write all the prompts for me. I'm just gonna feed it to Midjourney. Can we create something amazing? Let's find out. Okay, so how I plan to do this is just give the GPT-3 a simple line. I'm gonna start off with, give me one dark fantasy concept art idea. I'm gonna crank up the temperature to about 0.9 to be a bit more creative. The rest is fine, I think. Press submit. I'm gonna start off with just copying this whole prompt and paste it directly into Midjourney. If there are some words that can't be, I'm gonna edit it, and then we're just gonna see what we get out of it. Okay, so basically I just kept on asking for different prompts from the GPT-3. Every prompt I got, I just pasted directly into Midjourney. I tried to add some kind of aspect ratio, so I thought I just picked the ones I thought I would fit the most. So if it was like kind of a landscape, I picked like 69, and if it was more of kind of like a portrait prompt, I just picked 2-3. So yeah, that's basically what I did. Fed a lot of prompts and just picked out the top three that I enjoy the most. So let's have a look at them. Okay, so this is the first result. The AI came up with the prompt, a robotic angel. I just ran it a few times and picked out the one I like the most. I thought it looks really good. You can see like the four and different ones I got to the right here, and I picked the one on the top right. So very happy with this, very cool. Wow, so this was definitely my favorite. The AI picked out the prompt, an angel with black wings engulfed in flames. So if you see on the video there, the one I picked was the one on the bottom left. I guess they all look pretty similar anyway. But wow, so impressed with this one. I can't believe how good the flame and the wing looks. So very happy. Okay, so the next result we got was this one. The AI picked up the prompt, a dark and twisted take on the classic Alice in Wonderland, where Alice is now the only one who can see the true nature of the creatures he encounters. So I really enjoyed this one. I think it's really cool. Like, I really enjoy the details in what is supposed to be like Alice. And you can see the scary bunny, and there are some other details here in the background. If you see from the video, I picked out the one on the bottom right. So they were pretty similar, but I like this one the most. So if you enjoyed this video, I really think you should watch this one, where I go step by step trying to create the perfect Midjourney image. See you in the next one.